Hello and welcome to This Week in Warhammer. My name's Wade and I'm here to guide you through the next 7 days in your favourite hobby. We're getting closer to this year's Black Library celebration. Next week you'll be able to pre-order a range of stunning new models and amazing new books. Kicking off the Black Library celebration are two stunning new miniatures for the Horus Heresy. Fafnir Ran is the Lord Seneschal of the Imperial Fists, as unstoppable on the attack as he is unyielding in defence. And his twin axes, the Hunter and the Headsman, will easily cut through any traitors foolish enough to get close. Dominion Zephon had his Great Crusade cut short when he suffered terrible injuries at the hands of Xenos warriors. No less a tech adept than Arkan Land created his new bionics and got him back in the fight. His jump pack means he can zip around the battlefield, bringing his Volkite Serpenta pistols to bear where they can do the most damage. We're staying in the 31st millennium with the amazing limited edition of Sigismund, the Eternal Crusader. The legendary warrior Sigismund talks with a Remembrancer about his experiences in reclaiming the galaxy, and muses on whether the end of the Great Crusade means the end of war for humanity. This hardback edition is strictly limited to 2,500 copies and is signed by the author, John French, and comes with a soft touch cover, black gilt page edges, and a ribbon bookmark. From the Age of Darkness, we head to the Age of Sigmar. As Kragnos awakens from his eons-long slumber, he prepares to wreak a terrible vengeance upon the mortal realms. Can the followers of Sigmar stop the end of empires? Find out in Kragnos, Avatar of Destruction, available in hardback, ebook, and as an MP3 audiobook. It's been 20 years since the release of Dan Abnett's classic Eisenhorn novel, Xenos. The titular Inquisitor is drawn into a mysterious conspiracy and faces a vast interstellar cabal. The stunning 20th anniversary hardback features 15 brand new colour illustrations and author annotations, and a new afterword by Dan Abnett. The Successors is an anthology featuring a range of Space Marine successor chapters. From more established chapters such as the Crimson Fists to newer ones like the Emperor's Spears, you can follow the Imperium's finest as they try to protect mankind from the terrors of the galaxy. The book is available in hardback, ebook, and MP3 versions. In Astaroth, Angel of Mercy, the Blood Angel's High Chaplain is drawn by the Black Rage to assist the Red Wings chapter in the aftermath of the devastation of Baal. What Astaroth discovers will shake the chapters of the Blood to their core. It's available in hardback, ebook, and MP3 editions. Saturnine, the fourth book in the Siege of Terror series, is available in paperback for the first time. It sees Rogal Dorn and the Loyalists surrounded and unable to win every battle and required to make sacrifices in order to stand a chance of winning the war. This year's Reader's Choice sees Black Library classics back in print. Witch Hunter by C.L. Werner sees the notorious Matthias Thulman hunt down all manner of sinister threats in the world that was. Also back in paperback is Cadian Blood by Aaron Dembski-Bowden. It sees the legendary Cadians take on the forces of Nurgle in a novel that's part zombie apocalypse, part war story, all Warhammer action. This week, Forgeworld has two new Blood Bowl star players available for pre-order. Fungus the Loon and Bomber Dribble Snot are a pair of goblins that pack quite a punch despite their small stature. Fungus is the ultimate goblin fanatic, taking out opposition players with his ball and chain, while Bomber chucks explosives to blow gaps in their defensive line. Warhammer Plus hosts the premiere of the first episode of The Exodite this week. As anyone that's seen the awesome trailer knows, this is a show featuring the Tau Empire, but you'll have to tune in to find out who the title is referring to. There's also a new battle report where the brutal Auric War Clans take on the cerebral Lumineth Realm Lords in a battle of brains against brawn. The narrative from the End Times Book 4, Thankwall, is added to the Warhammer Vault, which sees the Skaven launch an assault on the world that was. We'll also have a jam-packed 7 days on warhammercommunity.com. There'll be loads of Black Library celebrations, including an interview with author David Geimer, plus further looks at the new Eldari Codex. We've also got all of our regular shows on Warhammer Live. If you've got any questions for this week's Hobby Clinic show, make sure that you ask them to our Twitter account, and we'll try to cover them in this week's show. To stay up to date with everything we've got going on, be sure to follow our Facebook pages, YouTube channel, Instagram, Twitter, and Twitch. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.